in will. And that's a penalty kick. Well, that shows you the referee isn't going to be intimidated. There was a collision and Rangers have been awarded a penalty kick, even though Paul Lambert remonstrates there. Tell you what, that's by any standards a courageous decision for a referee to make. That's the incident there. Pulling going on, and Vidmar judged to have pushed them down like that. Well, the Celtic players reluctant to get out of the penalty area. I was another supporter, come on. Wrestling in the middle of the penalty area. Well now, I have been at many an Old Firm game through the years. I don't think I've seen anything quite like this, maybe not on a scale. I think it was a 1970 Cup final when it was a huge crowd invasion. But it's as near to it in a league match as I've ever seen. So, George Albert. Possibly put Rangers two up, and he has. Rangers are now two up, and heaven only knows when this half is going to end, because I think we had a delay of about 5 minutes or something like that. And there's another supporter, come on. The wrestling in the Celtic penalty area, and the Celtic players are now trying to demonstrate, to remonstrate with the supporters. Here's the penalty, slickly put in. Fighting man he is as he's put away, and there's Dick Advocaat. Delighted with that.
No hesitation from Henry that time. To try to go on the outside. Okay. Taking his time about that. He measured it up very well. So gave that away rather easily. Good play by Celtic. Larsen, nice little ball through the middle there. And that's one of Celtic's better moves in the game. They spread the ball about. And again, at the heart of the play was that man, Henrik Larsen. Delightful ball through there. And Viduka, a good run by him, but just slightly off the mark.
That ball just outside the penalty area, and he really was befuddled that time. He simply did not know what to do with the ball. He was expecting players to come towards him, and he has to get that yellow card, of course, and it's a free kick to Rangers right on the edge of the box. There's where he had the rush of blood to the head. Delayed too long, and again that man causing them trouble. McCann, I think, has been quite outstanding. Well, we have Amoruso and Albert contemplating this. Not Amoruso and Albert usually duel for free kicks. Making a little discussion here as the Celtic wall is pushed further and further back. Van Bronckhorst hovering as well. Here's Amoruso with it, he's done it! Oh no! Yes, just over! Great save, it looked as if it was in the back of the net, and I think the Rangers captain imagined that as well. He did get it through that tight defensive wall. And that goes down as a great save. Wallace, and comes a German and puts it too far ahead of him, and Anoni has to step in at the last, and Rangers simply absorbing a lot of the play in midfield and relying on that sudden break upfield. I
coming in about 60 minutes remaining. And it goes to Johansson. It will turn into McCann. In goes McCann. He's going around the outside. He could do it here. He's done it. That does it. The championship is definitely heading for Ibrox. Their third goal, as I said, with about 16 minutes remaining. The inevitable happened. Celtic Park upfield. And the man of the match, as far as I'm concerned, the man who has caused them problems to the very end, ripping the defence apart with his break. Keeping his cool, always very difficult to go away in a diagonal as wide as that, but he came back in exactly the right manner. Rangers are three up. Well, the Celtic players sagged at that. They've given everything in the second half. To Larsson, Perini, a little bit slow going in there, and Colin Henry reading it again very well. Wallace, oof, dear, oh dear, oh dear. The tackle there was just amazing by Reset. And there's Anoni coming up. Now, what will the referee do about this? Reset's tackle and then the quite unnecessary retaliation by Wallace. So the referee now, and this summarizes how this game has gone, the commitment that's gone over the top at times. I think he's had enough of the yellow cards, of the red cards. And he gets a red card. Wallace goes off right at the end. And that's for retaliation. If you retaliate, raise your hand, you go off. Although I have to say, Reset's tackle was unbelievable. You don't retaliate, though. Larusso, you'll look for that longish one to Johansson. That's Johansson's 40, he's in behind a defender, but pushes. Free kick. Red for Reset. Reina is there. There's Colin Henry. Oh. And that's another one by Reset. Yes, he's going. I mean, that is unbelievable. He's already had a yellow card, and you know, the Celtic team, from that moment that Stefan Mahé was sent off, reacting in entirely their own way, losing that self-control and that self-discipline, which I think, under these circumstances, is absolutely essential if you want to win a football match. This game's going on around Europe, rest of the world, in fact. What an advert. And the referee brings the game to an end. Rangers are Scottish champions. Thoroughly deserved it. They were the better team of the night. There's no question at all about that. There could have been two goals up before the first goal, in fact, and before the 10 men. And they've won that championship. I have to say about the game, it's one of the most disgraceful I've ever commentated upon it on the old firm, and I've had many. The first goal coming, as I said, with the danger of McCann always present, darting in and getting that first goal. And then the penalty after the unsavoury incident of the referee being struck at an invasion of the pitch, coolly taken by Albert. And the third one eventually with the classic counter-attack. McCann, man of the match as far as I'm concerned, with his veritable pace, putting it beyond issue. But this game eventually, even though it has clinched the championship, decidedly leaves a bad taste in the mouth. Rangers, Scottish champions, winners by 3. 2-0.